Most people think they know all about the most famous volcanic disaster ever, but the factual story is even more incredible than the fiction. Hello, everyone. Thank you for tuning in to DNews today. I am Trace. This August 24th is the 1936th anniversary of the violent erasure of Pompeii from the shores of the Tyrrhenian Sea. I've been to Pompeii, it's beautiful, but it's also surprisingly expansive. The city of Pompeii is 3 square kilometers, and excavation has been ongoing since it was rediscovered in 1748. As archaeology continues, modern scientific techniques are teaching us more and more about that infamous day. Around lunchtime on August 24th, 79 CE, Mount Vesuvius exploded. Eyewitness Pliny the Younger, whose grandfather Pliny the Elder was a military officer stationed in the region, wrote, "A cloud of unusual size and appearance shot into the air from Vesuvius, reminding him of an umbrella pine tree. At its height on that day, Vesuvius's column reached 27 miles into the air before branching out and raining ash and pumice stones on the 2,000 Pompeians who hadn't already fled the city." We know this because Pliny the Elder and Pliny the Younger were eyewitnesses. The eruption caught people by surprise, many fleeing the city after the initial explosion, but before the city was completely buried by ash. But from surviving records, we know that there were signs something bad was coming. Fish were floating dead in the rivers leading up to the explosion, wells were drying up, and the vines on the slopes of Vesuvius inexplicably dried up. Not to mention increasingly violent and regular earthquakes were hitting the region. Today, we know that before volcanoes erupt, they swell slightly as the pressurized magma bulb rises up through the earth like a massive zit. Eventually, the mountain can begin to leak noxious gases, which might have contributed to the death of the plants. Measurements before the eruption of Pu'u'o'o on Kilauea in 1983 found 150 tons of sulfur dioxide was being released from the mountain every day. People who fled Pompeii on August 24th would have escaped the coming disaster. But just after midnight on August 25th, between 3 and 6 massive, superheated pyroclastic surges, which are like avalanches, but of rock, dust, and volcanic gas, and they travel at like 100 kilometers per hour, slammed into Pompeii, burying the city and the people who remained in volcanic dust for many hundreds of years. Looking at the distribution and type of debris in the ash layers, scientists estimated the velocity and power of the 79 CE explosion of Vesuvius at 165,000 tons of debris per second, with 84 rocks per square yard per minute raining down on the cities and temperatures reaching 482 Fahrenheit. A 2013 study in Nature Communications found a mass extinction event in the lower Cretaceous caused by a volcano resulted in exceptional fossil preservation. And Pompeii plays out something similar. If volcanic ash gets wet, it hardens like cement, preserving anything that's trapped inside it. Over time, the clothing and soft tissues of the Pompeians that were trapped in the ash decayed, and their dry, fragile bones and jewelry survived to be found today. Some of the most famous artifacts from Pompeii aren't the superb frescoes, houses, and even bread that is in the ovens of the bakeries, but the casts of the Pompeians themselves that we've today made. In 1777, excavators discovered an air pocket in the ash that was in the shape of a body. And in 1864, almost 100 years later, the director of excavations found a special mix of plaster of Paris, which could be poured into that cavity to mold out a body, revealing the heartbreaking detail of the last moments of these people. The wrong mixture of plaster can damage the delicate remains, so of the 1,150 bodies found so far, only about 100 have been cast into plaster. Today, Pompeii is a UNESCO World Heritage Site and is now feeling the pains of exposure to pollution, light, weathering, and water damage. After heavy rains not long ago, some of the buildings in the city collapsed, prompting new calls for preservation of this historic site. Even after preservation in volcanic ash for over 1,600 years, we could be losing Pompeii to the elements. Today, Vesuvius is the only active volcano on the European continent, and 700,000 people live in the death zones immediately surrounding the mountain. Ironically, they're drawn there because the ash and lava flows emitted by volcanoes create some of the most fertile soil on Earth. After a volcano erupts, the rock fragment particles ejected are called tephra, and over time, tephra breaks down thanks to chemical interactions from the atmosphere, resulting in that super rich soil. If you want to know what it's like inside a volcano, make sure you watch this video, because this guy went into one. It's pretty insane. We got to talk to him.
It also happens to have one of the few, I think, five or so lava lakes in the world, which is essentially a lake of molten lava that is exploding. It's about the size of 2 football fields.
So what about you? Would you live near a volcano, especially one that you knew was active? Let us know in the comments and keep coming back here every single day for more DNews, and make sure you subscribe so you can get those videos every day as well. Thanks for watching DNews today. We'll see you tomorrow.